to the Falconetti gunners. And this is very good because they can use them to destroy both the bridge we talked about earlier, as well as the all the towers. For the later stages of the game, they are bringing only one or two cavalry, so this is quite unusual. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it seems like they placed so far two or three culverins only, but this is not enough. The Falconettis were supposed to deal a lot of damage, but they were moved away with the trebuchet. And the bridge right now, 90% life. So this is going to be big up and heavy one from Wildblood, something we have not seen yet on our casts.
We see already some trebuchet going here and berserkers. They managed to break the stalwarts line and probably they will manage to go here.
Mm-hmm. So berserkers being very vast unit, they are one of the first to the front line, and seems like Wildblood is waiting with their push for other units which are much more defensive or bring more CC to the table, but they need to run and get here. So this is going to be still 10 seconds or so to the push, and right now they are using their trebuchet nicely to clear as much as they can to make this push easier. What I would like to point out is triple grapeshot setup from Akatsuki. This is going to deal a lot of damage if Wildblood players will not be watching out for that, and one of them is actually getting down, but two more.
Yes, it's already dual blades popping out, destroying this grape shot, and this is very big loss because defenders has only 15 piece of artillery, and they just gave up that tree so easy. Not dealing a lot of damage, because check this out. Already, Wildblood has 100 unit more.
Just doing it right now, so they are going to give up A for free, and this is going to be a clean sweep from B and A point from the attacker side.
And now, Wildblood has all time in the world to prepare attack. We see he forcing to Akatsuki team to switch the side. They can dedicate all on the supply point, and mm-hmm.
The supply point attack is actually coming
from
in.
The flamers, check this out!
Yeah,
the
flamers, imperial pikes pushing. That's devastating. This devastating for Akatsuki right now. They don't have anything left pretty much to stand here. There is hussars coming in, armingers coming in as well, but this is going to be too late.
But there is also a lot of another impike advance here. Come on, that is perfectly executed, and the Falconetti from the back just wiping the rest of the remaining troops from Akatsuki.
Yeah, this was very, very well played for Wildblood. The front line was very heavy, right? They really had quite a few of things that Akatsuki had planned to stop this push. Everything was countered with very nice mix of couple of important Golden Era units supported by a lot of heavy hitters.
Very, very bad charge. This was very heavy loss of the Amiga Lancer. They could be used later, but I don't know what is Gonzalez doing with that. And I was showing you guys from the second how Bambula and the Musket just killing another players, because they know they to have easy time on the last point, they need to kill as much as they can.
Mm-hmm.
Because remember guys, three lives rules.
Yeah, and the next clash is coming in actually. Wildblood very heavily keeping the pressure on Akatsuki, deciding to defend up front and personal directly at the C point. This is interesting. We have not seen this earlier, but we will see if this will be enough. As Wildblood have not lost too many units in the previous fight, they still have a lot of Imperial Pikes, Javelins, a lot of Falconettis and Pavais. All of these units are dealing constant damage and the defenders are falling down one by one. They don't have any more units here in the front line, and seems like this is going to be swipe of the units here.
Another charge with that with the Palace Guards, that wasn't that good charge. And check this out how even short sword, I know they need to chase.
Think up now, look at that, 14 yes. versus 7 only. 7 defenders from Akatsuki, we can see Imperial Shields, we can see some Stalwarts, and that's pretty much it near the cap point, unfortunately, for the defenders. So if they will not be able to get it short, in short time, it's gonna be fast match.
Imperial Shields are very good, but to soaking up the damage, but and the cavalry just wipe from the side, but this will be probably not enough, and this will be probably end of this game.
Yeah, we need to see more. We need to see more right now from Akatsuki falling into the cap point. The longsword managed to get in here, right? This is Darkman who got here. He still have full HP, so he's going to run around for another couple of seconds. Some units are going to make it, unfortunately. Yeah, this is over.
GG! Very, very, very nice job, but that was killed by this.
Yeah, quite a lot of berserkers. Seems like it's going to be quite fast push on B as well.
Yes,
a little bit. So at least they are trying to delay the push here from Akatsuki. We'll see how successful there will be, especially that they are heavily outnumbered.
Oh, first kill! In the moment when I see this Landsknecht preparing to charge, I knew there will be death.
Yeah, the damage is on point when they charge, right? But this is very hard to execute in a good way to not have this damage go to units or whatever. So nice pick over there. But for now, the status of the bridge, it's going to go down very fast. It's 10% left.
Yeah, I think only one berserkers will be able to go to the second side. If it's be like,
four players down from Akatsuki,
and I don't know how many units died there. There's already, check this out, there's already 200. Can you tell me?
Five
already. Wow, this is not good start. And the gate
is actually open, so maybe they will use this as an opening. It was not done earlier. Also, the wall is destroyed, so this is the first time we are seeing it. So they have two openings on the ground. This reach once more. Very problematic for attackers.
We see some small skirmishes in the bridge and in the gate. But this is only berserkers, and probably they will be stopped very fast.
Yeah, the advance is coming in from Wildblood, and the advance is going to stop most of the Imperial Pikes. The counter advance from Akatsuki is also pushing in with some supporting fire from the Falconetis at the back, but the Falconetis don't have too much to shoot from. Positioning from Wildblood is very good. They're not overdoing it, but they are dealing a lot of damage, especially that the Flamers are here up and close. Look at that. Everything is burning down. Units cannot move forward due to the fire, and we can see Shield Maidens from the left charging on their swords. They are very heavy on the damage in that direction. Last Imperial Pikes from the attackers are going to go down right now, and they are running for their lives. Akatsuki need to retreat.
And we have second attack here from some peasant and this is pike militia. Yeah, pike militia and stalwarts, and they trying to get into the wall, but they will probably stop by shield maidens.
Yeah, the idea from Akatsuki here was to attack both sides, take the attention through the gate, and they did it. But seems like the bridge.
I think they Akatsuki succeed with the pushing the one tower to the wall, because
two of those are on the field. Sorry, three to be exact. So this is going to be heavy in the damage side. And Wildblood is doing something very unusual. They are defending here heavily on A. I mean, 2 minutes left on the clock. If they will be able to stop Akatsuki here right now, they can do it. But Trebuchet is flying in, dealing a lot of damage. Charges are coming in from Akatsuki. Imperial Pikes are moving through all of the units, mowing them down. And it's looking quite problematic for Wildblood right now, as they need to watch out for Trebuchets and watch out for the flanks as well. So we'll see where it goes.
Oh, and Flamers come and clear the point. And they will probably slowly pushing the out Akatsuki, because there is nothing to stop them. Oh, maybe this trap if hit correctly, but one, two death.
Okay, three of the flames have died, so just two left. That's quite successful, but it's too late at it's that point of time. Yeah, most of the units are dead from Akatsuki.
It's too little, too late.
Dual Blade is going to counter him. If he's going to get there too late, it might be not that easy to do.
And he's right behind him with the units. That Tsunade is already abandoning this idea.
some fast flanking units to assist you in this B-point attack. Right now, 15 seconds on the clock, the push on the tower is happening, but this is unfortunately too late. We can see some condottieri, we can see some imperial pikes and some arquebusers coming in here, but most of the units, unfortunately, which are left for attacking side are blue or worse, so there is nothing they can do against berserkers, against palace guards, and against multiple players from Wildblood. GG, 2-0 for Wildblood.
GG, good job for Wildblood. Very, very nice game. Go to defend A point, but in the remaining time that